In the last problem, we figured out the theoretical yield. That's the maximum amount of product we can make. So we had two reactants, we found the limiting reactant, and then we worked from there. We said if we have 2.9 moles of oxygen, 2.9 is to 1 as x is to 2, did the cross multiplication, we found x is 5.4 moles of water. That's the most we can produce. But in the lab, there are often small errors or reasons that we don't get the theoretical yield. So we use a percent yield in the lab just to show how close we get to our theoretical yield. How efficient is the process that we're doing? So to find the percent yield, here's how you do it. So let's change the problem up here. And this is a typical percent yield problem. So the numbers here are the same. Our theoretical yield is the same. But now it says the reaction only produces 5.3 moles. So we're talking about in the lab. So to calculate the percent yield, what we do, we take the actual yield, that 5.3 moles, that's the actual yield, and then the theoretical yield right here. So they'll give you the actual yield in the problem, and then you calculate the theoretical, you do the division, we get 98.1, let's call it 98, we could call it 98.1, and that's our percent yield. So to recap, find the theoretical yield, you're given the actual yield in the problem. Use this equation here. You divide, multiply by 100, and that gives you the percent yield. That's it. This is Dr. B. Thanks for watching.